welcome to another edition of Andover's Town TV Spectacular. We've been up at the Mayor's Mini Marathon this week in Charlton. That was great fun. There's some great scenes coming from there. There's a lot going on in Andover. And today we've had news that the first cable telephone in Andover is going to be connected. That's quite a bit of history in the making. The first cable telephone is actually going to be connected in Andover. I'm waiting for a call from Comtel to let us know when it's going to be connected. And I'm going to try and contact Tony Murray, who's out on the road with our news crew, to actually bring you the event. But anyway, while we wait for that phone call, we're going to play you this opening sequence. And what Steve, the editor, has done is put a bit of some of the things we've shot over the last couple of years into the opening sequence. It's a really nice piece indeed. So I think you should see this. So anyway, take it away, Steve. Thanks for watching the show.
Town TV.
This is Town TV.
It's brilliant.
We'll be right back.
just had a call from Comtel, our cable station, and they said the first phone is going on in about 5 minutes' time. So I'm going to try and get a hold of Tony and the news crew. And it's Mr. and Mrs. Black. What are Mr. and Mrs. Black? You're the first person to be connected to the cable phone system, and you're in Watermills Close. So keep on watching. I'm going to try and get a hold of Tony now. Just one sec. Yeah, Tony. It's Al down at the studio. Just to confirm that Mr. and Mrs. Black are the first people who are going to be connected to cable phones. So you've got their address somewhere. So go along and surprise them. And I think they've got a little surprise. I think I may even have a little bottle of champagne. Okay. All right. On your way. See you later. Bye.
We're at Watermills Close, and it's a very special occasion. It's the first, very first, in Andover, telephone going through cable. And Mr. and Mrs. Black are the first people, and it's just being installed at the moment. As you can see, there's a great activity going on here. Now, we'd like to speak to Paul Hobart, who's the sales director, salesman?
Sales and marketing manager.
Sales and marketing manager. Paul, it's nice to see you again.
Thank you.
What's the advantage of having cable telephones?
Well, the advantage to all new subscribers as of today is that anyone who takes both cable TV and cable telephone service will be able to phone other cable telephone subscribers between 7 p.m. and 8 o'clock in the morning absolutely free of charge.
That's a really good deal, isn't it? Is it cheaper on the rental, or is it about the same price as BT or some other Mercury then?
It's cheaper than both of those people. It is £6.50 a month for the rental charges, and they can expect at least 10 to 15% reduction in their call charges as well.
Well, it's a great selling point for cable. It's got to be, hasn't it, with that sort of reduction.
Well, there's more to it than that. People taking the combined service of cable TV and cable telephony will be able to get the choice of a free premium channel for 1 month, so they make up their mind whether they like that and whether they want any other ones later on.
Well, this is wonderful. I notice you've got, what have you got here? You've got some champagne?
We've got a bottle of champagne to celebrate our very first customer for cable telephony, and we've got a bouquet of flowers for Mrs. Black as well.
This very minute, the phone, the very first phone on the cable has been set up in Andover, and Simon and Eileen are here, and we're waiting now for the first phone call. I hope somebody's going to phone. I think they are. We've set it up, really. So we're just hoping somebody phones very soon. So this is going to be pretty good for you, isn't it, price-wise?
It should be, yeah. Oh, yes.
There we go. Let's see who that is.
Hello? Hello, who's that? It's working, yeah? It's working. Right. That's great. Thank you. Bye.
Well, that didn't take too long, did it? They set it up at all. The other thing about it is that we didn't know anything about this until 10 minutes ago. That's what was going to happen. And I know that the guys up in Comtel didn't know. So everything was set up and done in a half an hour.
Yeah, no
and
trouble.
I think these guys have done a great job.
Very
a round of applause
for
Comtel. They've done extremely well.
Very good.
No trouble at all.
I believe that Paul Hobart has got something for you outside. Shall we go and see what it is?
Right, yeah. Right.
Hey.
Oh, isn't this wonderful?
You can join in as well.
Oh, I'm driving. Well, I suppose a half a glass won't go in this.
Thanks.
Well, congratulations on being the first.
Yeah, thanks very much.
Oh. Go on, cheers, Mrs. Black.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thanks very much.
Thank you, Paul. That's fine.
On behalf of Comtel, may I ask Gareth to present you with this bunch of flowers.
Thank you very much.
Best of luck. Happy doing and happy calls.
Our very first telephone subscriber.
Thank you.
Cheers. Thank you very much. Cheers.
Cheers, folks.
Cheers.
Thanks very much.
May I just say that we asked our service department about 30 minutes ago that we required this home to be connected to our telephone system. And here we are, 30 minutes later, they've already received their first call. I know the network manager was totally unworried when I said to him we needed to make the connection tonight. And perhaps you'd like to say a few words. John Howard, our network manager.
This was the first of many of the installs. We expect to be doing about 1,000 a month. So let's hope you're one of them. Okay.
Thank you, John.
Where did you put it in, John? I can't see any wires anywhere. Right. So how did it go through?
It's over here. Right, we dug along the path here, put a swept tee outside the wall and made the connection there, ran it round the wall and up to the primary jack point inside the house.
Well, right. For a half an hour, this is absolutely wonderful. There's no disruption whatsoever. I think it's excellent.
Well, we have what a good crew doing it for us.
Pleased with the job? I'm very pleased, yeah. Yeah, like I say, it was half an hour, really. Come straight in and it was done within, well, no messing at all. That cleared up the mess. Fine.
Excellent. I can't wait to rush back to the office and give you a call. We'll speak to you soon.
Yeah. Thanks very much.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Cheers.
It will last.
Yeah. Hello. Oh. Hello, I've just been talking to my general manager, Mr. Ian Renshaw. He's a Scotsman, so he's not famous for being generous, but he has, under the circumstances, offered you free line rental now because you've been so good at entertaining the media and the press and everybody else. So you're going to have free line rental for a year.
Yeah?
I'm very pleased
to tell
you.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Oh, great.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
Lovely. Wonderful.
Well, Tony's been a very busy boy this week. He's actually gone down now to Smith's. It's WH Smith's in the High Street, where John Deacon's going to be meeting the mayor of the Test Valley. John is the singer whose record got... the singer from Andover, whose record got to number one in the Irish chart. So John rang us up and said, I'm going to be meeting the mayor in Smith's. So take it away, Tony. Smith's in Andover High Street.
Right, we're down outside WH Smith's, and we came down to see John Deacon. You may remember John was on the show a couple of months back, and what happened was, the story I'll take you up to date, one of his kids phoned GMTV and said, my dad can sing. So the producer promptly got on the phone and invited John down, and things have been happening for John since then. First of all, who phoned?
I phoned Director Inquiries to get the number, and I passed it on to Charlotte, just in case I mocked it up or something.
Well, your name is Sean?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Charlotte.
Laura.
Jane.
Jane.
What's you told me, what's your daddy?
Superstar.
He's a superstar. Well, of course he is. All good superstars come into Andover to talk to Town TV. John, it's good to see you again.
Nice to meet you, Tony, too, again.
What's been happening since?
Lots. Since I last saw you, as I told you, we went on GMTV and ended up on Kenny Live and Radio 4 and that. After I spoke to you, I was asked to go to London and meet the record producer, and he gave me another contract for 4 albums to make with him. I'm in the process of making one at the moment. I've just learnt 15 new songs, Irish ballads, of course. And since then I ended up on the Vanessa show on up at Norwich.
Yeah.
Then I was flown out to Jersey, and I'd done Jersey Television and also Jersey BBC and what have you. Lots of stuff, and biggest shock was on the 17th of March, was I found out that Michael Howard, the Home Secretary, had booked my record in Ireland and wanted to meet me.
Oh, excellent.
And it was all arranged for me to meet him on the 17th of March in Folkestone, which I did. And very, very nice indeed, you know, the way we were treated and everything. a lot of panic around with Special Branch and everything, as you can imagine. And then a week after that, I got a letter from the Prince and Princess of Wales office congratulating us on my record and also on the children.
What are you doing down at W. H. Smith's in Andover today?
Well, we've been promoting the record. The record's out now down there in Andover and all around the south and everything like that, and selling very well, I'm glad to say. I've just met the mayor and the mayoress, who's given me all their support as well.
Very nice people, they are too, aren't they?
Lovely people and what have you, and very proud to meet them, like, you know. So now I'm in the process now of just, I'm off to Northern Ireland, next week, and I'm doing a program called Kelly over there.
Yeah.
And then I go out to Germany, to Berlin, to do a program there. And then I'm off to America then. Somehow I've got to try and do an album amongst all the middle of this.
Oh, this is excellent. So it's excellent news. I mean, it's a story that goes back, when did they first phone them?
A year last Christmas. They phoned GMTV as I was on income support, yeah, and my marriage had finished. And basically, £80 a week trying to bring up four children at Christmas. And
not
they
asked,
no, it's very tough being on income support, believe me, I do know. And it was Sean who came to me, in fact, and said, Daddy, can we have some money to buy you a Christmas present? And I had to admit, I just didn't have it. Yeah. I said, you know, as long as I can get you a present, I'm quite happy, Sean, I said, but don't worry about me. Let's just get Christmas out the way, like. Yeah. And Sean got it into his head with the girls to ring GMTV up and see if they'd wish me happy Christmas. Because in the morning, you see, I'm getting the cereals ready and getting the kids ready for school, and I always watch the news.
Yeah.
And he knows I watch the news, and the idea was, I think, to be a surprise for me that all of a sudden Eamon Holmes come up and say, oh, happy Christmas, by the way, to John Deacon.
Indeed, yeah.
But it went a lot further than that, yeah, with the singing and what have you. So, it's we all feel much better for it all now. It's given me a better chance, give them a better future.
This
and,
you
know, it's made us all feel a lot better.
Well, they're all
looking
very well, aren't they? They're lovely kids.
Thank you very much.
Very lovely kids. Are you going to, have you thinking of doing any live gigs at all?
That's lined up. As soon as the first album's released, then they're trying to get gigs together in Ireland for me. And like I say, basically, it'll be a lot in England and what have you.
Yeah.
They're trying to get quite a few things lined up for me in London and what have you at the moment. Because the management team, I'm with Deer Park Productions. I have management with them for 3 years now.
Yeah.
And an awful lot of radio work being done at the moment and stuff like that, you know. And my record actually in Tunbridge Wells, I had to go to Tunbridge Wells because the minute it went into the shops, it was sold out.
That's
so I had to go up there again, yeah, and meet the people there. And I met the mayor in Tunbridge Wells and things like that. But basically all over England, it's doing very, very well for me, I'm glad.
So from Christmas 12 months ago,
that's right,
you've shot into Starling.
Well, I suppose you could say that. Yes, indeed. You know, it's a big shock, you know, but we're enjoying life. You know, I mean, I'm 38 years old. I'm no youngster.
You're only a youngster.
Well, I don't know. I'm 38. But I mean, you know, being 38 year old, you sort of keep your feet on the ground when you've got four children anyway.
Indeed.
Which is a good thing, I feel, you know, and if I can give them a better future out of it, and it does us all the world a good out of it, then all well and good. You know, as long as people like my music, that's all that matters, really.
Well, that's great. You know? John, when your new album comes out, will you come down and talk to us again?
I'd love to come and speak to you, Tony. Thank you very much indeed.
Thanks very much, John.
Thank you.
We had roadside stops for bread and cheese and
good afternoon, I'm Bill Murray, you may remember, and this week, instead of being at an exhibition of professional artists, I'm at an exhibition of art done by members of the Enham Trust. We're all disabled people living in and around Andover or at Enham Alamein. It's a most interesting exhibition, lots of very competent work, and I'd like you to meet Vivvy Mallock, who is one of the instructors at the art classes held at Enham. Vivvy.
Hello.
Hello there, nice to see you. You actually are an art teacher and a sculptress in your own right.
Well, yes, I teach at Enham, and I teach on Mondays in my own studio, and I do some sculpting. They're all at Enham, they live and work at Enham, and they go on Wednesday afternoon. We have an art group, 16 of them, and this is a selection of their work. They all try terribly hard, they all have qualities, some are in different colour, and some in drawing, some in oils, painting, some in, even in sculpture, we haven't got any here now. And they all put all their trial feelings into it.
Right. Yes. Thank you, Viv. It's been
That's
very
okay.
nice talking to you.
Thank you.
On my left at the moment is one very well-known personality, Tony Hart. I'm going to see if I can get him to talk to me. He's very busy at the moment and being very, very professional looking at the art. Excuse me one moment.
There we are. It's a pleasure.
Tony, could I interrupt you for a moment?
Yes.
Town Television. My name's Bill Murray.
Bill.
Your camera. Tony Hart, of course. Very, very well known. Wonderful children's entertainer and artist. For his creation of a wonderful character called Morph, who might well have been, I don't know, the precursor of the sort of animated characters we see in The Wrong Trousers and things
absolutely
like that.
Absolutely right. Same stable, of course.
Really?
That wonderful animator he didn't create Morph, of course. Morph came about, it must have been, when was it? Do you remember? 1964, Vision On started, went on for 12 years. At the end of that time, it was Take Heart, and that's when Morph was born.
Was he your creation mentally?
Rather like the camel. We always think that God and a committee made the camel, and Morph came about in exactly the same way. We all got together. What was happening, of course, was that in the Vision On series, there were three of us. I think our viewers will remember that we had Pat Kiesel, always a clown of some sort, didn't we? And me, doing the sort of art side of things. And when we were doing this series called Take Heart, it was just me at the start, and they wanted something else, something that I could talk to maybe or spin off, but they didn't want a human being. And that was why and how Morph evolved. And he evolved out of the strange little plasticine animated things I call them, yes, that had been used towards the end of the run of Vision On. And Morph obviously was called Morph because the metamorphosis of the plasticine going through the table, you know, and all this, right, yes, this sort of thing. But I always said myself that it was because he, Morph, was Morph, Us and Bother than anything else on the programme. I've been involved with MenCap for a great many, about 17 years now, and annually we have an international art exhibition in London. And I have to say that while many of these artists are in no way mentally handicapped, but there is handicap throughout all this. There is no handicap where art is concerned very often. Yes, sometimes a person, a man or a woman or a boy or a girl, is incapable of using their hands to do things. We have seen work done with brushes in the teeth, haven't we? We've seen feet go to play in work, all these things. But here we have very reasonable, ordinary people who, one way or another, have problems. They have produced an exhibition of art here. You look around these walls and you see what's here. It must have done them so much good to do it. And today, it's doing them even more good to realise what we, the public, are thinking about.
Sure,
their work.
We're rating their work even higher than perhaps they did.
Exactly. Yeah. That's exactly what we're doing. And isn't it well worthwhile?
Oh, it certainly is.
Yeah.
Could we, in a minute, perhaps have a look at one or two of the pieces and your comments on them?
Yes, of course.
Fine, thank you very much.
To.
Tony Hart, ladies and gentlemen. In a moment, we shall be looking at some of the pieces of work here, and I know we'll get some very interesting comments from him. See you in a minute. Thank you, Tony.
Thank you.
I'm going to creep up on Tony, who's talking to Christopher Jenkins at this moment and looking at some of his work. Come on, let's have a look.
Do you have too much colour?
Listen to this.
Listening over your shoulder.
Listen to this.
Would I reckon to me that's too much colour?
Now let's just get this right. Now, Christopher, you are pointing to a little red dot underneath a superb, yeah, picture of yours.
Of one of yours, yes.
Why I like this, it has a feel about it. Now, you know, in Africa, they adore colour. And among the Zulu people, they have a way of art.
Three very, very interesting pictures on the wall here at the moment, done by Patrick Baker, who's standing by them, and Tony Hart's having a look at these at the moment.
We've got landscapes, we've got houses, we've got hillsides, and he hasn't been afraid of colour. It's all there, and it tells us what it is, and we have our own feelings about this. Down here we've got
really difficult.
Yes.
So it's normally I do sponge painting. Or
so do I.
I love sponge painting.
I adore sponge painting. even finger painting.
Yet another really interesting exhibition of art in Andover. Most surprising, the sort of things that turn up here. Last week we had the exhibition of professional artist at Bob Herbert's. Today it's here. Tony Hart's going around talking to everybody, looking at everybody's pictures. Unfortunately, we don't have time to do that. There are upwards of probably 80 pictures here. We really haven't got all day to look at it, unfortunately.
Well, big thanks to Bill Murray and all the Enham artists who were exhibiting up at the Andover Museum. Go to the Andover Museum. It's well worth it. I mean, it's a great place, and it's just behind St. Mary's Church. All you Andover people who haven't been to the Andover Museum, go there right now. It's the Iron Age Museum as well, so it's really good. Do you know, I was watching the David Letterman show last night on one of those American channels. Have you ever seen that? David Letterman, late night. And do you know what he did? He walked up to the cameraman and he went, like that. And I thought that we should do that more on Time TV, so that's what we do it again. I mean, sometimes I get so angry with the staffers on Time TV that I go raving mad. Also on David Letterman, he had rats running around the ceiling, and fake rats, you understand, not real rats, but I think it's quite funny. If you point up, Steve, maybe you'll see something. No, maybe not. No, the studio ceiling's a bit tall, I think, but Swifts, but no rats. If you watch the David Letterman show on cable TV, you'll get the joke. Anyway, this is not joke time. This is not competition time. This is a link to the commercial break. So take it away, Steve.
So, now what do we do?
Go to bed.
We are not sharing the same bed.
Why not? I think we've established a rapport.
A what?
You drink Old Blend. I drink Old Blend. We're already coffee lovers.
This is a blanket, and that is a chair.
Rich coffee aroma, smooth coffee flavor. Nescafe Gold Blend.
Mark?
Yes?
Nothing. Some things in life are hard to swallow. Such as paying for your home contents and buildings insurance in one large lump sum. A general accident direct. We let you pay by instalments. Without charging you a penny in interest. How appealing. For more information, call 0800 121 004. General Accident Direct. The name you can trust. Colonial Direct. How can we help you?
0800 828 500. Colonial Direct. Now we're talking.
At the sweet shop, it's a tease at half price. Choose this and this. This settee is half price. Or choose this three-seater settee, and this two-seater comes half price. Choose any combination with five seats or more, and the sweet shop gives you a settee half price, and interest-free credit as well. So, it's half price settees at the sweet shop. Don't miss it.
Well, welcome to Charlton Sports and Leisure. Here we are, surrounded by thousands of people. It's that time of year. It's the Andover Mini Marathon. We've got about 3 minutes to go, so we're going to try and see what's going on. This way, Ollie. So perhaps we'll go through this way. There's a Ducal people over there. Look, they look very industrious. Lots of teams here today from Andover. So here we go. Follow me, Ollie. We got Red Rice Health and Fitness over here. There's a team from Advert. So,
you can feel this tension here this afternoon.
Hello, Red Rice, how are you guys doing?
Right, yeah. Doing fine.
Are you gonna win this, aren't you?
Not a chance, but we'll have a go.
You're meant to be fit, aren't you?
Well, yeah, but there's some fitter guys out there.
There we go, there's all the teams from, as I say, Ducal, and off to a very hectic sprint start, but other people are obviously going to take it a bit easier. There's some people bringing up the rear nice and steady, but obviously the idea is to get round to the end. So it's a long way to go yet. Right, well, we're here with the mayor and his good wife up at the track. Good morning to you.
Morning.
It's a great fun event, annual fun event for the people of Test Valley. Not just Andover, I mean, many of the villages and Romsey and areas around. So it's a proper Test Valley event.
So you're telling the course is about 2.25 miles long. So if I just hold that up so the viewers can have a look at that. And it goes all the way around Charlton Lakes. All around there, yeah. So that's about 2.25 miles. So they're expected back here shortly, I suppose. Really,
10 minutes for the first one, they say, which are a little over 10 minutes because the first ones are the fastest. Oh, yeah.
So there we are, viewers. In about less than 10 minutes now. We should be expecting some of the first runners to come past. So
that's right. But that will just be the first leg, of course. The 600 team. So then another one will take over and. Until they all six have run.
So how long do you think the event's expected to last?
Well, I suppose anything from just after 2 o'clock for the really fastest ones to about 3:30, maybe 3:30, I should think.
Okay, wonderful. Well, thanks very much for talking to us yet again. And how are you enjoying your season in office?
It has been tremendously worthwhile. We've committed ourselves to the borough for the year, but it really has been very heartening to us that the vast number of people who are doing voluntary organisations, who are doing voluntary work in the borough. I mean, we've had some fun events as well. I mean, today is a fun event. So great.
As I say, thanks for coming yet again. You're doing a sterling job, both of you. Thank you very much. Well, as I say, there's lots of people on the track here. This is a team from Ducal. What's your name?
Richard.
Where are you from, Richard?
South Wanston? Yeah.
Say hello to your friends in South Wanston.
Hello, friends in South Wanston.
Where are you from?
South Wanston.
You're from South Wanston too. Okay. So, we've got the first runners expected in a minute. They're coming around, aren't they? So how far are you going to run?
I don't know. The whole thing.
Whole thing?
Yeah.
Really? Okay. Right, well, thanks for talking to us. See you later. Yeah. There's another guy. There's more Ducal over here. Look. Are you Ducal?
No, I'm Twinings.
Twinings?
Twinings, yeah.
Yeah, we've been up at Twinings. Where are you from?
I'm from Sunderland.
Yeah, but where? Do you live in Andover or not?
Yeah.
You do? Whereabouts?
Riverway at the moment.
Say hello to your friends at Riverway.
All right, Riverway.
What's your name anyway?
Kev.
Hi, Kev. There's somebody a bit colourful here, Ollie, look. What's your name?
Rhonda Smith.
Hi, Rhonda. Where are you from?
From Monkston.
From Monkston. Say hello to all your friends in Monkston.
Hi, Monkston! And also the Mayor's Appeal Committee, because I'm on the Mayor's Appeal and I'm running for the Mayor's team.
Great stuff.
For the Euro Rebels.
The Euro Rebels.
God save the Queen.
God save the Queen.
This is not a political statement.
This is not a political statement. Hampshire Fire and Rescue Service was there. Here we go, number 117. The Hampshire Fire and Rescue team are actually in the lead at the moment, and they seem to be winning all the races around Andover. Everybody's dressed up here in a wide variety of costumes. So where's your runner then?
Well, they're running at the moment.
moment, we thought he was number three, but he obviously isn't, because he's taken longer than, is it? Because they put the good ones first. And we were told categorically that we wouldn't be allowed to walk it. So I'm getting a little bit nervous here, thinking that I'm going to have to run.
Is the Euro Rebels team running in fancy dress as well?
Yes. We are the Euro Rebels. I'm in the team.
Are you running in that? Oh, goodness. Sorry, I just thought you were cheering on.
No. No. This is why I'm getting a little bit concerned.
Yeah, but Simon Miles said they're going around at 10 minutes per lap, which is very, very good indeed. Two and a quarter miles.
So we're out at Luggershaw again. We always seem to be going, the smell in here is gorgeous, but the reason we came out this week is, yet again, this man has a habit of winning things. Now, there's something a bit unusual about this. Well, maybe Alan will tell us what's going on here.
Well, this time we've won the speciality class for the New Forest Sausage Competition and also taken the runner-up prize as well.
So you got two, first and second?
First and second, yeah.
That's highly unusual, isn't it?
It is really, because, you know, you usually get might get a winner or a second or a third prize, but to win the thing, to both take both prizes is really good.
That's excellent. What particular sausages did you have in this one? There wasn't one particular one that you had to enter.
No, this was a speciality class. We won with the pork and tomato, and the smoked pork and apple was the runner-up.
Are they very popular here in the shop as well?
They're not quite so popular because both are fairly new sausages, so they're getting more and more popular now. The smoked pork and apple we've developed over about the last 4 or 5 months, and we've really got it right now.
That sounds like a really good one to try, so come along and try that. There's so many sausages here, you can spoil for choice, especially coming up with this nice weather. Barbecues, be here. Thanks, Alan.
Thank you very much.
Alan, there's a fine pig dressed up in the window. What's this all about here?
This is our VE Day pig. He's just advertising the fact that we're running a little promotion for VE Day, and we're trying to collect somewhere around about £1,500 for a commemorative plaque in the church to honour the war dead of Luggershaw. And in return for this, we're asking for a small donation into our little white pig here, and we will give you a free raffle ticket, and with a bit of luck, you'll win a year's supply of sausages.
A year's supply of sausages. Yep. It's an awful lot of sausages.
Yes, well, it's a pound of sausages every week for a year.
Yeah. So that's almost, what did you say, £100 worth of sausages?
About £100 worth of money, yeah.
That's a brilliant prize. Now, where do they make the donation? When they come into the shop?
When they come into the shop, yeah, just pop a few coppers, whatever you can afford, into
in the little white piggy, one?
In the little white piggy, yeah.
And they get a ticket for that?
You get a ticket, yeah.
And how long will you be doing this for?
We should be running about 4 or 5 weeks.
Yeah, so the draw will be made then?
Yes.
And we'll be here with the cameras to see who's won.
That's right. Well, why not? We need somebody independent to draw the winning ticket out, don't we? So why not have Town TV come and do it?
We shall do that.
Okay, thanks very much.
Well, welcome back to Charlton Sports and Leisure Centre. It's a Test Valley Mini Marathon. This event's been sponsored by AB Training, JUCO and the HSA. And also, of course, the Test Valley Council. So, as you can see here, there's beautiful... beautiful scene going on. We've got double deckers. We've got the Punch and Judy show over there, which no doubt Ollie will go and have a look at later. And Simon Marlowe from 210 FM, he's still broadcasting away. And we're now well into the race. And at the moment, the Hampshire Fire Brigade is in the lead. So they're rushing around. But it's not particularly who wins. It's a question of taking part. So there's loads of people from the area taking part. We'll be right back. came in quite ahead of the pack there.
Yeah, it was a fast start because the bend was a bit tight. So I got around the bend and I just had to hold off there, and Heflin was with me most of the way and we just paced each other around. So that's why we come in together.
That's about 2.25 miles, isn't it, Ryan?
Yeah, roughly 2.25 miles. I was aiming for about 10.5 minutes, but I think I got under that, so I was pleased.
That's easier than running around the Chantry Centre, isn't it?
Definitely, definitely. I was waiting for that race this year, but it didn't come on.
No, we're going to do it again next year, so right, you can hold on to the prize for another year.
We've got another year of it, so right.
Maybe we'll do it right here next time. Okay. Right, Caroline from Red Rice. The owner of Red Rice. How did you do today? Did you do well?
Well, we did really well. The first achievement was that we got 10 teams running with 6 people in each.
Yeah.
So that's 60 people we had running from Red Rice.
Good heavens.
And then when the results came in, we found that we'd won the best sports club team.
Yeah.
And we also won the mixed team, and we came third in the veterans team. So we were amazed and delighted. It was really good news.
That's fantastic, isn't it? I mean, Red Rice is going from strength to strength. What else are you doing over there?
Right, one of the things that we've got at the moment is an 8-week special membership.
Sorry, getting surrounded by all these trucks pulling army lorries and things, but we'll battle on regardless. Okay. We do that on Town TV, so.
We've got special 8-week membership packages. Yeah. The campaign's called Spring Into Summer.
Yep.
And it's particularly designed for those people who are looking to start a health and fitness campaign ready for the summer. And if anyone's interested in that, the thing to do is to give the club a call. And
I think we'll get Steve the cameraman actually onto
why
this.
Not? Why Steve not? This.
He did it last year at somewhere in Andover, didn't you? Where was that? Oh, don't mention where it was, but anyway. But anyway, he's getting a little bit of a time there. We're not really viewers, but we're going to get him on the Red Rice Health and Fitness campaign.
That would be really good. Yes. It's an eight-week programme. We put together a personalised programme for anyone who joins in.
Yeah.
And we'll look after them terribly well. And if they want to give us a call, we'll arrange a time for them to come and see the club.
So look into that lens and tell everybody your phone number.
The telephone number. It's an Andover number. It's 710-555. And ask to speak either to Adrian or Caroline.
Red Rice, health and fitness. There you are, keeping us all fit here.
That's
look at
great.
That. How can they keep me fit on bacon burgers? But anyway, great to see you guys. Thanks for watching the show, and we'll see you later.
But the winner, Team 125, with an outstanding time, beating every record that there has been since this actual event began. 1 hour, 1 minute and 15 seconds, which is a brilliant time. The Hans Fire and Rescue. Come on, put your hands together for this. 1 minute, 15 seconds. They were last year's winners, but beating that time by about 5 minutes. It's a brilliant time.
Hiya, how you doing? We're back at Luggishall Garden Centre. What are we doing back at Luggishall Garden Centre so soon? It's bedding plant time. The wife sent me down on a mission. They've got over 45 different varieties of bedding plants here, and that's just the flowers. They got vegetables as well. Just a small selection in here. It's massive. Hanging baskets, the lot. I've got to get the hanging baskets up. Do I know somebody with a screwdriver? Don't worry, we'll find somebody. They got absolutely everything down here. All the seeds, all the flowers you want, all the vegetables, the trees and the shrubs. I could go on for hours, but there's not time. Come down to Luggishall Garden Centre. What have they got? They got the lot.
Welcome to the John Hanson School. It's a big night out here tonight. In fact, it's a fab night out, fashion and beauty. And here we are with Julia.
Hello.
And who we got? Hang on. Julia and Elaine.
Hi.
Elaine and Paul.
Hiya, all right.
Paul and...
Hi. Hi.
Rachel. And you're the dynamic duo. You're from Duo Boutique.
Yeah, that's all right. Chantry Centre, Andover.
Chantry Centre, Andover. And just opposite you is?
Is Foster's Trading Company.
Foster's Trading Company. And Julia?
I'm from Morse's Catalogue, who are a worldwide organisation.
It used to be with American Express.
I did, yes.
And we got a little letter from you, dated 28th of April, said, please come and see Fab. So here we are. This is what we're doing tonight. So why did you guys sponsor this show? You first.
Good question.
It's a great turnout there. You've got hundreds of people here tonight.
Yeah, we just really wanted to show off our range of ladies' wear.
You're quite a new shop in the Tranchy Centre, aren't you?
Yeah, we've been there 12 months now, on June the 4th.
How's it going?
Yeah, very well, thank you.
Because you're right at the top, opposite Foster's. Is that a good position or what?
Yeah, it's a fairly good position, yeah.
Great. Selling lots of clothes?
We hope so, yes.
Are you showing anything tonight? I'm not going to cut that because I enjoyed asking that. Ollie the cameraman never stops laughing and things like that.
Well.
Have you got any clothes on display tonight? She's got the giggles. I'm going to Paul.
Well, we're used to this, aren't we? No, we thought it'd be an idea to do the fashion show to support John Hanson School and their Parent Teachers Association. But our target market has now gone between 15 and 25, so it's a younger image, even though the 25 to 35 age group is still important. This is a good opportunity to impress the higher grade people at school, as well as the youth.
It looks very professional set up tonight, doesn't it?
It does look very good, actually. You should be impressed with this, Alan. This is more your scene, isn't it?
I should walk on down the catwalk, really. And you're with Duo?
Yes, really. We're hoping to try and create some awareness tonight, just for those people that haven't been into Duo, and also for people that still come in and say that our prices are expensive. We're trying to obviously show people that they're not, and they're getting value for money.
It's nice to have something a bit upmarket in Andover, really, isn't it?
Yes, I think so. A bit different from all the other shops.
Yeah. A lot of bargain basement shops. It's nice to have something
a bit classy.
Well, you're opposite a classy shop as well.
Exactly. Yes, yes. Two classy shops together, and both value for money.
Right. Got over your giggles now.
If you think it's a giggles, you want to go backstage.
Can we go backstage, Ollie? In fact, we might even go backstage in just a minute. So, anyway, we'll wait for the runway to get into operation. See the runway. See, I've done this before. The runway, you see. I don't think Claudia Shiver's going to be on tonight, but you never know who's going to be on tonight on Town TV. So see you in a minute. Bye for now.
Yes,
so how did you come to organise all this?
Well, they wanted new events in our PTA calendar, so I offered to organise a fashion show.
Really?
So,
do you regret it?
I do, yes, it's very much so.
It's a full house, it's brilliant.
It is, it's fantastic. I'm really pleased with the turnout, wonderful.
Where are we going now?
We're going backstage now.
That's what I like.
Where the beautician and the hairdresser.
And 40 models.
And 40 models.
Ollie, there's 40 models behind
you. Should be fun.
Are they all female? Or
no, there's some male.
Oh, all right then. Okay, here we go. Here we go backstage. Live on Town TV.
Here we are.
Here we go. Here we go.
It's one of our hairdressers, Donna.
Hello, Donna.
Hi.
How are you doing? Say hello to Town TV.
Thank you. Hello.
Here we go. 40 model. Oh, my goodness.
This is my sister, Sonia.
Hi, Sonia. Say hello.
Hello.
Where do you live?
I don't know.
Do you live in Andover?
I'm not, yes.
You do? Say hello to all your friends. Hi. I'm really shy tonight. Oh, goodness me.
Fiona, this is
Town
TV.
Hi, Fiona. How are you doing? Do you live in Andover?
Yes, I do. Thank you.
Say hello to everybody in Andover.
Hello, everybody in Andover.
Okay, right.
Decent girls.
Are you all decent?
Yes.
Well, this is pandemonium backstage, isn't it? What's your name? Hello. What's your name?
Claire.
Claire, where are you from?
I'm from Andover.
You're from Andover too? From where?
Andover, just in Wessex Gardens.
Right. Say hello to all your friends.
Hello.
We're going to watch you in a minute. Come here, you. What's your name?
Helen.
Helen.
Rainer.
From where?
Don Hanson, Andover.
Say hello.
Hello.
Okay. Right, we'll see you on the show on Friday night. So, okay, right.
Friday, what
time? Oh, you never know.
No.
All depends on Ollie the cameraman. Right, here we go. What happened to Julia? She's just a bit around there. Hang on a minute. Hello, what's your name?
Kerry.
Kerry. Say hello, Kerry.
Hiya.
I'll see you later. Well, we're going to the showers or what? I think we've just exhausted everybody now. Ollie, come out the showers. Right. It's more... So what are you doing? Telling people how to actually...
Trying to. We're just running through the last minutes of practicing with all the models.
Yeah. Are you nervous, you guys?
Yes.
There's loads of people out there. Plus a TV camera.
They're more nervous now.
Great.
It's hot.
Say hello to all the... I want a big wave. All right? A big wave. One, two, three.
Oh,
What a beautiful day. I think I've said that before, but it must be about 83 degrees.
Or something like that. It's beautiful. I stay out here. I'm not working in that office anymore.
Your little white shirt, I tell you what, it's reflecting off the sun.
Yeah, the white hair as well is reflecting. I don't need a cap because this reflects the sun, so I'm fine.
What a wonderful day. Enough of this banter.
What's that banter?
Well, I don't know. It's been a long week, and it's a holiday weekend coming up. So if you watch the show next week, the weekend's been and gone, but never mind. We're looking forward to it, aren't we, Tim?
So if it's after the weekend, I hope you enjoy the weekend.
What have you been doing?
I'm just going up to a golf club now.
You're going to the golf club?
Yeah. It's to do with a charity. Yeah. So I'm just going to go up and interview a few people and hopefully promote the charity a bit. So that's what we do in Town TV.
That's good. I spoke to Derek Baker yesterday, 3H Motors, and he said he's going to be up there.
Yeah, apparently they've got to show cars up there and things like that. Maybe test drives. Not over the greens, I hope.
Nothing's name dropping. Anyway, we've got a quiz for you, as we always do on Town TV. And Steve's going to play the fanfare now, I think, if he can find it. Da, 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 da.
He obviously didn't find it.
He didn't find it, so we do it in four.
All these questions.
Steve's going to keep fit too out at Red Rice. That'll be fun. Won't it, Caroline Blatchford out at Red Rice? Yes, it will. Steve's going to go and keep fit. Right, it's a VE Day competition, and you're not... Do you know what VE Day stands for?
Victory Europe, I think.
You got it. That's it, yeah.
And was that the competition? Did I win?
No, you didn't, no. It's musical question time. Musical question time. And as Tony's the muso, actually, all you people out there, if you don't know what muso means, it means musician. So I'm going to pass the mic to you.
Thank you.
And the first question.
Really difficult stuff, this. Who's the Force's sweetheart?
Who is the Force's sweetheart? That's question one. What's the prize? Oh, we didn't say about the prize.
Well, what is it?
The prize is, in fact, Chrissy organised this. This is a fantastic prize.
Very special. Unique thing as well.
It's unique, and it could be worth many thousands of pounds in years to come, even next week. But what happened was, Chrissy rang up Steve Humphreys, the jeweller in Andover, and said to Steve, can you create something special for VE Day for our competition? And he said, yeah, I will. I'll design a piece of jewellery for the winner of this competition. Steve's workshops are up in Birmingham, and as we speak, he's up there in Birmingham.
He's sweating over a hot...
Working away, making a beautiful piece of jewellery for the winner of this competition. So we don't know what it's going to be, but as I say, it could be worth a lot of money. So great prize. Piece of jewellery made by Steve Humphreys from Andover. Humphreys
and Julius. Prize, then.
Anyway, we'll go back. That's question one.
Who's the Force's sweetheart?
Who's the Force's sweetheart? That's the first question.
No, this cracks me up, I'm afraid.
Go on. Question number two.
Yeah.
What flew over the White Cliffs of Dover, and what colour was it?
Wonderful.
What flew over the White Cliffs of Dover, and what colour was it? Was it a plane? No, it wasn't. Over the White Cliffs of Dover, and what colour was it?
Yeah,
and three.
Three is what was hung on the Siegfried Line.
On the Siegfried Line.
Yeah. Hangout.
I never could sing.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's what do you mean, yeah? So anyway, what do they hang out on the Siegfried Line? So the three questions are, name the Force's sweetheart. Question two, what flew over the White Cliffs of Dover? And what colour was it? And three, what do they hang out on the Siegfried Line? So they're really good, they're three really good questions for VE Day.
Puzzle everybody.
That'll puzzle everybody, yeah, but it's a great prize, this piece of jewellery. So, anyway, ring
in.
Last week's winner. Tony, the bucket. Yeah. The golden bucket.
The bucket.
Steve, how about you drawing the award?
Come on, Steve, you come and get this. Come on, Steve.
Come on, Steve, come on. Steve's going to draw this award.
The gold bucket reveals this week's winner. I can't read that.
It's
Is that Damien...
Darren.
Darren? Darren Parrish?
Darren Parrish.
It could be Darren Parrish. We got the telephone number. If it's...
Yes.
We'll have to check. I think it's Darren. Yeah, Darren Parrish.
Darren Parrish, probably.
But we got your phone number. Darren, if it's not Darren, it's Damien, or it could even be Dawn. We'll go for Darren. So, yeah. Darren, you won a meal for two at Simon's Wine Bar. And the answers were, who played Simon Templar? Well, it could have been Roger Moore or Ian Ogilvie, or there was another one, I can't remember who that was.
That was before our time.
And there were a couple of other... the other questions were, name a famous English actor with the name Simon. Well, you could have had Simon Williams, Simon McCorkendale, and the guy from Heidi High. What was his name, Steve? Do you remember? No, I don't remember. There's quite a few guys. And where is Simon's? And, of course, if you've won the prize, Darren, you want to know where Simon's is, and it's in the White Hart Hotel in Andover's Bridge Street.
So well, he knows because he answered the question, didn't he?
That's right. Well, but it's for the rest of the people who didn't answer the question. Okay. So as you can see, it's a mad holiday weekend here on Town TV. But I think just a serious note, you know, the celebrations for VE Day, 50 years since the end of the World War II. Yeah. So I think really we should, you know, there's 2 minutes silence on Monday.
There is, yeah.
So, you know, it's not all fun. There's a lot of people gave their lives up for this country. So just remember that. Anyway, have a great weekend.
Well, we're going to be very busy this weekend.
We're going to be very
busy. So many things happening.
Yeah. Okay. So we'll see you guys soon. Thanks for watching Town TV. Oh.
We're going to finish with the Miller.
Oh. Thing. So as a special tribute, we're going to run the Herb Miller Orchestra for you because they are great. So I'll bring back a few nostalgic memories for all you guys out there. So anyway, thanks for watching the show. See you next week.
See you.
My name is John Miller, and this is the Herb Miller Orchestra.